Hello there guys, it is QWERTEE Afro. Welcome back to my series on Fernbus Coach Simulator. Today we are continuing our route that we've already began in part 1, which was route 220 by Flixbus. Found the route online. It goes between where we started already in part 1 at Mannheim and goes all the way to Erfurt, if I'm saying that right, Erfurt. And the reason why I'm actually doing this particular route is someone suggested I do a route to Erfurt because that's where the actual studios are for the devs that actually made this game, and apparently they did that city pretty detailed because obviously they're situated in that city. So I looked up on Flixbus.com, saw 220 that goes from Mannheim, which was the last city that we came to when we were doing Route 009, and thought, hey, let's do to Erfurt, and, you know, we're doing one. And we are already halfway, sort of, I think just under halfway there. We've done the kind of bulk of picking up passengers from Heidelburg and Darmstadt, and now we're here at Frankfurt, where we still have to pick up our passengers that are going all the way now to Erfurt, which I do believe, Erfurt, getting there with the German names, I do apologize. Before we get into it, shoutouts do go to, in this video, Harry Brown and TCDAM Mania. That's again Harry Brown and TCDAM or TCDAM Mania. The links and stuff will be down below. Show them some love. Again, please do not request shoutouts currently because I'm trying to go through the current list I have, and then once that list is finished, people that have another shoutout can then start requesting again. Cool. So, we're here at lovely Frankfurt, as you can see. Just outside the kind of main station here, I suppose, the main kind of big station building. Each city appears to like have one of these kind of really huge kind of hub buildings or whatever, so let's get on with it. I'm in my coach. I think I have everything really. Just everything is just where it is, basically, left off since the previous episode. Let's open up that. Even though I think the luggage already has been packed up already, so we just basically have to do check-in. Hello there. So we're going to have actually a lot of people. I think we have 15 people in total here to actually pick up, so it's going to be a bit of a while going through the names and stuff like that. We have Stephen Burmeister and going to Erfurt. Stephen Burmeister, he should be on the list. There he is on the list. Welcome, Stephen. Welcome aboard. Tristan, hello, Erfurt. Yes, Tristan, you're there. We're just going to go quickly through these because a lot of people here. Okay, so this is a passenger who hasn't actually booked a ticket, wants to go to Erfurt, which we are going there today on this route 220. So let's find Erfurt. Let's check her in, generate her a ticket. Booking number, there you go. Get some extra income. We love extra juicy income here at Flixbus. Hello, Ledion, Radmacher. Are you on our list today? You should be. Yes, you are. Well done. Welcome aboard. Hello, Josephine/Kern. Josephine/Kern. Yeah, it's even there on my app. So she's probably typed in her name wrong when she was actually buying the ticket online. Welcome, Josephine/. Emilia Steinert. How are you doing today, Emilia Steinert? We have another Emilia. We have Ben Berner as well. But yes, but you're on the list. Welcome, Emilia. Hello there, Milena Werner. Are you on our list? Yes, you are. Welcome aboard. Hello, sir. You are Giuseppe Schwartz, I do believe, if your name's on the list. Where are you? Giuseppe Schwartz. Am I seeing his name? I can't. Yes, there he is. Giuseppe, if I'm saying that right, I don't know. I do apologize. But welcome aboard to Erfurt. Hi there, Lucian Linder. You are on our list, Lucian. Welcome aboard. Express check you in. Thank you very much. Welcome aboard Route 220. Another passenger that we wants to buy a ticket right here on the spot. I like it. The extra income is good. So we have 22 people that we're going to be picking up, but then an extra two now, so probably 24, which is really nice. Why is this woman have a suitcase still? I don't know. Emilia, hello. Berner, yes, you are on the list. Thank you very much. I think this is just a random passenger just stays, probably the one that we dropped off already. Some like to just stay behind and just gander around here. Amy Gahart to Erfurt. Yes, you are on our list. Welcome aboard. Guys, can I get in here? Does anyone have a ticket? Omar Schreiner. Yes, you are here, Omar. Let me check you in. Welcome aboard, sir. And hello, your twin. Who your twin's called Lionel Roth. And Lionel is here. Let's get you checked in, Lionel. Who are you? Please, Heidenrich. Erfurt, that is all fine. Heidenrich. Pui, yeah, there you go. Welcome aboard. Timmer Ramers. If we can find you, Timmer. Yes, Timmer, you're on. Thank you. Welcome aboard. And who are you? You are Jet Anders. You're right on top of my list, Jet. Jetta. And you are just a random passenger. Do we have any passengers here waiting that have just maybe finished up a coffee or something here? No, we don't. Let's just quickly have a look here. Have I actually checked in everyone? I have checked in everyone, which is very good. Everything is checked in. That's nice. Perfect. So that is everything done here in Frankfurt. That last stop now is Erfurt, which is the long drive. It's quite a bit of a drive, so I hope you're going to enjoy this episode, where it's going to be just a perfectly nice drive. We're kind of late here. Do you really want to skip until a minute before departure? Oh, we're so early. Oh, look at that. That's a new thing for me in the videos, being early. We're supposed to depart at 10, but we're here at 9. Okay, we'll skip to the minute before departure. Why not? Oh, okay. See our destination display up there. I think it's only going to say Frankfurt now, or is it going to still just... It'll say everything. Right, let's close up all the baggage compartments. There we go. Everything is in order with my bus. You know, do some, you know, round checks and stuff. You know what, like, pilots do and whatnot. I'm guessing you have to do it for a coach as well. Cool. Let's get this back door closed. Perfect. Right. On the road we go. Look at this almost full bus. Everyone's here going to Erfurt, where the devs who actually made the game that you're in. Right. Let's get the PA on. Oh no, we need to turn on the engine, I do believe, don't we? There we go. And now I can do... Now I can do the... Can't do the... Why can't I do the PA? Okay. I can't do the PA for some reason. That's weirdly odd. Okay, we just won't do the PA this time. Doesn't matter. Oh. And one thing I forgot to do is put on the, I have the sat-nav there on the screen down below, but I cannot see that for all my life. Let's get the navigation on. That should be fine. I'm really surprised that I can't... I'm really surprised I can't... Did it say the AC was too hot? We'll lower it down white by one. But for some reason, the, PA doesn't want to work. Doesn't matter. We'll carry on. It's just a bug. And I'm gonna ignore that red light. We had the green light there. Right. Getting here to take a right. All good. Hope everyone is... Can I get to the... Hope everyone is fine back here. What the hell is that? Oh, that's a billboard outside. Oh my god, that's scary. Like, I was wondering, like, what the actual hell is that? I thought that was in my bus. It's not. Ooh, clipping the curb a little bit. Bit naughty. but we're all good. Right, this is going to be a very nice long drive kind of video. No stops in between here. This is just pure driving now to Erfurt. Hope you guys enjoy it. We have quite a bit of a way to get out of Frankfurt, as we found out in the first part. Frankfurt is a pretty big city in this game. Quite a lot of stuff, you know, to go around and drive around, and it has its own airport as well. Which I do believe it's the only kind of like separate airport kind of stop that you can actually do as a route on a route, which is pretty cool. And there are kind of lines and stuff that I've seen on the Flixbus website that does Frankfurt Airport, and actually the night bus version of this route that I'm actually doing does include Frankfurt Airport on its journey. Just for some reason doesn't include it during the day, I don't know why. Maybe Flixbus only just does, like, say, Frankfurt Airport and whatnot during the night when, I don't know, like, during the day there's, like, other companies and stuff that do shuttle services to the airport, so it's maybe not viable for Flixbus to do the daily kind of routes and stuff to airports. I'm not too sure. They probably do have airport lines during the day. Just, I don't know about them. Stop. Oh, that was close. Right, let us transcend. Right, bit of a sharp one here. Should be fine though. That's all right. But I can't go now because there's another set of traffic lights just up ahead, so gonna have to wait till traffic now moves as it is now, which is good. Carry on forward. Look at that though, 294 kilometers, not miles. We had this discussion in the previous thing about me and miles and kilometers and miles per hour and kilometers per hour and whatnot. I won't repeat it again. And probably during this actual journey, we're probably going to have to take a rest at the rest stop at some point. So we'll definitely, it would be cool to actually have a look at some of the rest stops along the journey. Fuel, I don't think we're going to need to really worry about fuel, but the rest stops that are on the way probably would have a fuel stop as well with it, so we could fill up if we really want to. I'm too slow. Okay. I'm too slow and I'm coming up to a red light. Ooh, should we put down the... No, that's not the button. Put down the blind, that doesn't work. Someone commented actually, like, when I was complaining about the actual blind in the Route 9 video. Someone was saying they should put shades in the game for the coach drive, which is actually a good idea, to be honest, because the blind actually, it just doesn't work. Right. And it's still ever so beautiful out here with the snow that we're getting. Very nice. Again, no kind of changes with the kind of road, with the kind of driving style, even though the road should be kind of more slippery due to the ice, but I don't really feel any kind of difference. It feels pretty much the same, in my opinion. Right. Are you gonna let me through, bud? Yep, thank you. Okay. Okay, that was my fault, I would say. I merged a little rough there. Right, so these kind of speed restriction signs that you see now on the road signs actually do not apply to me, because I can only go up to 100. Oh, what's this? Oh, is this? Oh, roadworks. Oh. Oh, I see here. Look, is this kind of like lanes and stuff that have been like normally when you have roadworks and stuff on motorways, they thin out the lanes a bit. Oh, that's really cool. To be honest, for me, when I actually see this, this kind of puts like spite in my mind, because like when I drive on the motorway and when I see this and have to drive through this, it's bloody annoying, because like the speed limit goes down to 50 and it's super annoying. Wait, what the hell happened? It's because this is super thin, but my coach can't actually fit in here. And I got some steering misbehavior for no, like, I'm not even steering. So I'm gonna have to keep a little bit actually out here, a little bit out wide, so I don't actually scrape the barriers as I just did, stupidly. Because this coach is pretty wide, and because of roadworks and stuff going on here, I don't know if this is actually part of the events and stuff that's actually turned on, I'm not too sure. One thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna turn off the lights as well, keep the dashboard clean as we continued it in the previous episode. In the previous part, I mean. Well, episode as well. Okay, I like that. That's good. I think that's probably part of the events and stuff. Maybe some of the roads get closed off. Some of the roads get a bit narrower there with the lanes and stuff. I like that. That's very good. And I saw an AR car just suicide there, which is kind of funny. I think that's a rest stop there. And I'm not going to use this one. I think I'm going to use the next one, if you remember on the map. If I actually go to it right now. So, you saw on the map where I showed that there was two rest stops here in between on our journey. I'm not going to stop at that one. I'm actually going to stop at this one here. We'll have a look, take a rest, and see what's what. So, I'm going to skip this one here. Do a bit more driving, a little bit more up north, closer to Erfurt. All good. Not too much traffic, which is very good. I still haven't like fully witnessed the events and the events kind of thing in this game. Like I have it turned away all the way to max, but I haven't really, you know, witnessed it too much. Maybe that there back there with the roadworks could have been the sign of it, but I've seen like things in other videos where like literally a slip off road is closed, so you have to divert your route. I've seen police chaperone and pull over like vehicles into rest point areas to like check documents and stuff like that. That's what's actually like different events that can happen, which I think is super cool. So I can't wait to see them or experience them. I just hope none of them are that bad that I have to like drive all around Germany just to get to Erfurt, which would be kind of annoying. You need to, okay, so right now it says I need to take a break, so we're just going to drive up now until that kind of a resting place up ahead that I showed you guys on the map. So, but look at this, this is so beautiful. Look at the foliage, look at the snow, it's all nice. It's, you know, the road's kind of snowy, slushy, which is pretty cool. Let's put on cruise control. Just relax into it, really. Am I going to have to overtake here? I think I am. Because you guys are going slower than my assigned cruise control. But thank you for not doing anything stupid when I overtake. That's nice. Now, can I go in there? Yes, I can. Now, I think I'm just continuing straight, because that goes back down. If I turn off right here, we actually go back down to Nuremberg? I think. Okay, heavy accident. Really? We're all gonna die. Late merging there. Like, I think they really do need to work on this AI, though. We're going round here. Oh, okay, we're doing a loop-the-loop kind of thing. They really do need to work on the AI. It definitely needs some tweaking and whatnot. I'm going to start slowing down here because we're taking a curve here and we don't want to really execute this turn in too much speed and go drifting and doing Need for Speed and whatnot. I'm going at a perfect speed executing this corner, guys. If you want me to go faster, then I'll end your lives. Literally. There we go, perfectly done. I wish this notification thing would go away, like, after a while. Like, I get it. I need to, and this is maybe something that they maybe could add maybe to the, like, say, to my sat nav or something, so it just stays on there. Like, say, in Eurotruck, it shows you the sleep, the tired symbol and whatnot. It shows you your damage or whatever, instead of it just popping up, or customers just popping up and just telling you stuff. I don't know. Because I do find it a bit annoying. And I'm actually seeing that my side mirrors may be fogging up a little bit. So maybe when we get to the rest point, we'll turn on the demister. Because right now, I do not want to turn down and press a button and drive. Because we'll probably get into another heavier accident. There we go. Need to watch out on, like, keeping in mind, because this coach is bloody wide. I think that's the actual issue here, why I'm crashing into people here on the left, because the coach is so wide, I can't really keep it fully in one lane, even though I should be able to. There we go. Cruise control's on again, so I just can nicely cruise. And look at this. Look at that pickup truck on the fastest lane on the outside, while people just, like, essentially undertaking him in the middle lane. Whoa. Did you just see that in the side mirror there? Whoa, that was crazy. That was, like, trippy. Like, the fence basically just came close and came up to the side of my bus in the side mirror. Luckily, hopefully, that didn't affect it physically, because if it did, we would have, like, crashed and scraped and whatnot. I'm not too sure. But everything is going smoothly. I'm liking it. I'm just want to have a little gander here. See, okay, that's okay. That's good. That's fine. That's a river. Okay, that's a river. I thought maybe that might be like a future road or something and put it in, but that's actually just a river. So we're just going to take this right, and then it should... Okay, I just wanted to get a rough idea where the service station is. Taking a right off here. Very nice. Good execution. Hope everyone on board is having a lovely time. Coffee and biscuits are served in the back. Wi-Fi is available, so you can go online, go into YouTube and watch some QWERTEE Afro while QWERTEE Afro is driving you. Oh. Good. The good. That's nothing. Nothing's coming on my left. Doing some extreme merging here. Right. Oh no, this isn't a lane. This is still a hard shoulder. Good. Okay. Cool. Right. So the rest station should be coming up very soon, I suppose. Unless it's like closed or something like that. Something funny like that. It'll troll me. I know, like, this game will troll me, like, in the kind of... Like, I want to do something in it, and then it'll just, like, go, nope, you can't. But it's been good to me, this game, so far. I'm not gonna lie. Again, the patch has really helped in terms of the AI stopping at red signals. I'm really excited and eager to see what they're gonna be patching next, what they're gonna put in as well. Would be really cool. I would really want to see some features now start to get in, like bugs and stuff are cool, and I welcome more bugs, changes and whatnot, but I'd love to see now more features that they promised get added into the game, so that my experience just evolves, really. Now, do I want to overtake here? Because I don't know if this rest stop is coming up, because I don't want to overtake and then have to really quickly, come back into the lane. No, I don't think it's coming up. That's fine, we're good. I really need to stop driving I have this habit of just verging a little bit more to the left for some really weird reason. I don't know if it's just... It's probably the width of the vehicle or something like that. I don't know. Yes, I know we need to take a break. And we're going to be taking a break, guys. Don't worry. we're coming up to that juicy service station where you can go in and buy your meal deals and get your Starbucks or Costa. I wonder how a German motorway service stops. I wonder how they differ to like the UK ones. Like, do they have like Starbucks or something like in it, or whatnot, or like a, you know, a road chef or something like that equivalent? Not too sure. If anyone's German here knows their bit about the motorways and Autobahn on in Germany, and knows the like service station companies and whatnot, feel free to hit me at that. Oh, hello, you're here. Oh, I wonder if you can zoom out on the sat nav, because it's just sometimes it's literally last minute, and it just freaks me out. Like there, Oh, this appears just to be a rest station, so there's no. Oh, hello, nice parking spot for me next to the lorry folks. Wait, hold up, wait, what? I didn't even park, and it. Okay. So I didn't even park my bus, and it just automatically goes, hey, you know what? You're good. Is that an actual place? Rashtov? Is that an actual place that you can, you know, go to on the motorways in Germany? I'm not too sure. But apparently we've done our rest. Or whatnot. Let me actually higher up that blind. Put up there. There we go. And then let's put on the wipers. Wait. Why is... Oh, there we go. The parking brake was on. Wait. Why are my wipers on like crazy? I didn't want them on crazy. One more down. No, one more up. That's fine. Cool. Anything coming from there? Nope. So that's a bit annoying. I hope that gets fixed. Like, just you drive just a bit inside the rest area, and then it just automatically goes, yep, you rested. Like, I'm gonna park. I'm gonna park myself. You know, I don't wanna... Okay, that was weird, but... There you go. That's what resting looks like in this game. Hopefully something that they can fix, because I want to, you know, park up my... Oh, hello. Okay. And one thing I hate... the one thing that I keep doing that when I want to overtake, I look in the mirror, I don't see anything, but then when I start, like I did there, I started overtaking, and then an AI car just appears, because it just, like, it just kind of, there's, like, a bit of mist or something like that in the side mirror, or just, like, the fog generally in the background or whatever, like, where it gets procedurally generated or whatnot. The car just appears, and then I'm just like, I can't really react. Oh, yeah, I said I wanted to put the demister on for the side mirrors. Can I... get back into lane here. Thank you. That's it. I wonder if I can be really cheeky and actually go into the view. Now, whoa. Oh, that was quick. That was really quick. And luckily, we were really good about it, to be honest. Like, really, really good. That was close. But I'm a professional, so, you know. Whoa, this sun. We definitely need some sunblind action down here. I'm sorry, that is really, really strong sun. There we go, turn off the wipers. Saying slippery road surface. Well, thank you. Even though I don't really feel the effect of slippery road surface, because I don't think it's been simulated in. Oh, let me turn the wipers again. I think that's the slowest setting. Cruise control again is on. Let's pull up the sunblock. We actually don't need it. Well, that's why it's weird. We had a bit of sun glare there and then just vanished. Maybe just we're facing the wrong side of the sun now again. Which is good. It means just less glare. I'm happy if there's less glare, to be honest. But I'm never doing that again, though, where I flip to the other cameras just to press a button, because that was really scary. That was tense. Like, I was literally like, as soon as I pressed the wrong view, I was like, oh my god, I have literally seconds here to correct myself and just get to the correct view and change the button. Oh, we have another road here we're crossing. Very cool. Not too far to go now, only about 69 miles. But tell me what you guys think as well, like, people that actually have this game already. Tell me, what trips have you done? What cities are your favourites so far? I'm rather liking Frankfurt, because obviously it's like one of the biggest cities I've been to so far. Like, what's the weirdest bug you've seen? Maybe that's like a kind of good topic to actually even discuss, because obviously right now when the game's kind of full of them, in a way. Well, not full to the brim full of them, but you know what I mean. There are bugs in it. Like, what's like the weirdest bug or the funniest bug that you've encountered so far? Oh, hello, here we're gonna have to stop. Wow, this change in speed is ridiculous. What the hell? Like, look at this. We're going literally at like 20 miles an hour. What the hell? Jesus. Oh my god. Let's put down the window a bit. I get why the cars are slowing down here, because obviously there's other cars merging. But look at that car, it's still going slow. It's a bugged out AI car. A bit of colour there with the like a sunflower field, very nice. What was that on the right? It was like some like abandoned lorry or something like that. It was like an abandoned MAN truck or something like that. It looked like a fairly new MAN truck, to be honest. It's probably like a farm or something, I assume. It's getting slow down here because we're pulling off. There we go. In the distance somewhere is Erfurt, which we're coming up to. I really hope... Oh no, it's not, because we're taking a lefty instead of a right. What is actually over there? I want to actually have a look. What does that sign say? It says... If the camera won't bug, oh no, I can't zoom out anymore. No, I legitimately can't actually have a look what's actually over there. It says, I think Dresden. I think one of them is Dresden. Oh, look at that turning skill. Very nice. Look at our MAN coach go. And we go back. I can't do that for too long. Yes, green lights. That's what I like to see. I might be on a little B road or something now into Erfurt, which would be really nice. Do some country driving. But we're down to 70 kilometers per hour. Oh, hello. Take a left here. Let's have a look at the signs of what cities and stuff that we get here. So up ahead is Halle and Weimar. Nicely does it. Beautiful. And I think we're in Erfurt now. I do believe. And this is already looking very, very different. Like, look at the scenery here. Look at the houses and stuff. Look at the superstore there. Completely different to what I've been actually seeing elsewhere in the cities that I've been to. Maybe this is definitely the devs' city. And I wouldn't be surprised if it is, because this looks completely different. I'm getting a complete, total different vibe here. What is that? Some roadworks there up ahead? Yeah, I suppose. Oh, and the light, when you zoom in, the lights stop. For some really weird reason. And now they stop as soon as you pass. Oh, that's weird. Bit glitchy there. But I'm really liking this town. It's very nice. Or city, I should say. It's very nice. Definitely a different feel. Handbrake on. Right. Is this... No, I'm trying to guess what this is. It looks like a Citroen Saxo. No, not a Citroen Saxo. A Citroen... Oh, what's it called? I don't know what it is. Oh, to the left of us is a VW Transporter. Or VW something van? Or I don't know. I think it's a Transporter. There's a Transporter Combi minibus or whatever. Been enough with naming AI. Could just do a video where I just like watch AI and just say, oh, that's a Mercedes E-Class, or that's a VW Golf. That would be fun to do, but maybe. Maybe one time. Oh, hello, we're taking a left here. This city definitely feels very different. Again, their head is another squirrel logo. What's that? Medways, some craneage and stuff like that. Also, like once they update like passengers in, I mean, like pedestrians and stuff into the game, the cities will look a lot more lively. Right now, they do look very, very ghostly. But that's something they're going to update into the game soon, and that will hopefully spice up the environment a bit, because right now it just feels very ghostly just driving into here. Very nice detailed city, but just oh hello, we need to take a left here. Very nice. Is that a river down there? Was that a train? I'm not too sure. I think it's a river. Oh hello. There we go. Bit of a sharp turn this. Bit of sidewalk works there going on. More sun glare, like it. Oh, I can see. Okay, we're doing loop-de-loops around to get to this bus stop, which is kind of fun. Final turn-in. There we go. Oh, wow, this is... look at this. This is some sort of, Bahnhof. Oh, look at this. This is a proper train station here in Erfurt. This definitely feels like a completely different kind of world compared to what... Oh, and this is the bus stop here. Very nice. Simulation Forge. Oh, so is that like achievement, like saying that this is like their place? I'm assuming. I don't know. Anyway. Let's get out. Have a look-see around. Look at that. We've made it to Erfurt, guys. Very cool, very swag. I like it. Let's get the all good. Someone told me that some of the baggage and stuff left behind could be like the driver's luggage and whatnot, which I guess is pretty cool. And I've seen, on some of the Flixbus videos, real-life videos and stuff, that some, routes have two drivers, which is pretty cool as well. Like, you see, you have a little seat here for, probably a co-driver, I'm assuming, so they take in shifts to, drive and whatnot, which is pretty cool. But anyway, all our passengers are here, all 22 and a few more of them, which is pretty cool. I'm chuffed about arriving here at Erfurt. Which is very nice. It's a very beautiful city, and definitely feels completely different. And I'm not gonna say it's more detailed, but it does feel like a completely different layout and whatnot from what we've been seeing so far. But hopefully, maybe all the other cities I go to now will probably be a different layout and whatnot. So time will only tell. I hope you guys enjoy this. This was Route 220 from all the way from Mannheim that we did in the first part. And then in this part, we did Frankfurt to Erfurt now. And I enjoyed it. Very nice town, city. This is what I've seen so far driving into it. It's very nice, very detailed. And our customers are happy. And we're actually holding up a bit of a traffic jam. And that's an Audi TT. The shoutouts for this video go to, Harry Brown and TCDAM Mania. That's it, again, Harry Brown and TCDAM Mania. The links to stuff down below. Show them some love. I will see you guys in another, another video, another Fernbus video. Do go on the flixbus.com website, have a look at some of the routes and tell me what kind of routes would you like me to do. I'm now in the north here, Erfurt. I can't start again at cities that I haven't been to, so I can start at Erfurt, Frankfurt, Darmstadt, Frankfurt, Heidelberg, Mannheim, Heilbronn, and all those cities and the cities I've done in the prior episodes. I can start from all of those. So, go have a look on Flixbus. Tell me some of the routes that you might want me to do and whatnot. Other than that, I'll see you guys next time. Bye. Oh, quickly before I sign out, I'm very sorry that I didn't actually do this. Let's just log out and actually have a look at the statistics. So, let's have a look. We transported 43 passengers, which is pretty cool. The highest that we've transported so far. Tickets sold, we sold 2 extra. Everything looks good here. Stops complete 5, which is good. Contact with Central. Yeah, this is something I keep forgetting to do at the stations. I keep forgetting to hit start ride. It's such a bad habit now. It's just literally, I think about it at the beginning when I do it, but then when I get to the next station, it just goes off my mind completely. I don't know why the hell I do it, but something to improve on, as I keep saying in these episodes. Fueling, we didn't do any. Run out of fuel, we didn't run out of any, which is pretty good. Service, plus on schedule. What does that mean? I thought we were on schedule. Like, we actually had to catch up we had to, wait for the scheduling in Frankfurt because we were early. Scheduled departure 4 out of... What? I thought we were on time on most of the beginning ones. I don't know. Schedule arrival. See, that's fine. Maybe the departure was a bit different. That's fine. Air conditioning is always going to be a bloody problem with this game and these customers. Property's damaged. Yeah, we'll just skip this. And steering misbehavior. That's speeding limits. Maintain. Yeah, 98%. That's right. Safety distance broken. Yeah, whatever. All good. All good. We did well. And now I will see you guys in another video. Bye.